It's that time of the week again. Welcome to the Gamer Jets Duo podcast number 17. That is my intro. I might stick with it. I don't know. It's that time of the week again. We do it every week. I don't know. I'm trying to think of some things. That's the first experiment. I'm one of your hosts, CBCAC, but you can call me Teddy.
And this is Dasani.
This is Dasani. Welcome our third and permanent co-host, Dasani.
Dasani. Stay fresh.
Stay fresh.
Fresh.
Are they sponsored with Subway in any way, shape, or form? Because they should be.
Nope. They should be.
Yeah. Stay and drink fresh or whatever.
Stay and drink fresh.
But or eat and drink fresh. But yep. This is Eric, my co-host. Yep. This is an entertainment podcast where we mostly talk about PlayStation, Destiny, comics, superhero stuff, TV, movies. That's about it. Games. Mostly games, but that's just a lot of the different subjects that we cover.
It depends what's going on in the
That's true as well.
Room.
That's true as well. Yeah. So, before we get into what we've been playing for the past week, dang it, I almost did the timer and did things professionally, but I didn't, and now it's doing things. But, before we get into what we've been playing, I want to toss it out there to anybody who's watching the YouTube, or if this goes well, somewhere else. I have recently been slowly working to add our podcast to different podcast services, as in like in audio format, to iTunes and to all the Android apps and all that. So it's kind of a like process. Really hard process. Like people don't I've known a lot of podcasts that are like just on YouTube and then they don't even put it on other in audio format on SoundCloud. Other apps until they freaking like get a Patreon where that they're right. getting money to do it, and I'm doing this for free. So it I mean, to be honest, I think I have it like figured out mostly, though. I think it should be at least some of them. It's very likely that it'll be up by next week, maybe. Cool. it's like a 65%
I mean, we only
70%
have...
chance.
How many episodes do we have? This is the
17. It's yeah. a lot more than it seems.
Yeah.
It actually, to be honest, it does seem quite yeah. quite impressive. But yeah, this is 17.
Well, compared to 300.
Yeah, but I have to like I basically have to make like a blog post to turn it into an RSS feed and then submit the RSS feed to iTunes. But like I have to make a post for every episode, so I basically have to go through and like resubmit every episode with the thumbnail, with a new thumbnail, which I think I'm done with making all those, but with yeah. a new thumbnail for each one, and the title, and the description, and the tags, and the actual audio format, which I had to convert the video to audio. So once all those are up, then I can submit it to iTunes, and then we can get it rolling. So hopefully, next time, we'll have some new viewers, perhaps. But
and people can take it on the go.
Yeah, on the go. I actually used to always watch my podcast, because like I have two monitors. I would just play something and then have the other one on the other screen. Right. But recently, like a lot of the games I play, I don't do that anymore. I mean, I still do a lot of the time. But other times, like, I'm just driving places, so I just put it on my phone. That's what I've been doing lately. I'm like halfway through the Ear Biscuits with Markiplier.
Yeah.
I'm listening to that in the car. After this, when I go somewhere, I'm gonna be listening to that. Yes.
Ear Biscuits, of course.
That's why the whole thing started, where I said that it was odd that you're listening to it on SoundCloud, because it's on.
It's on. I know. I like SoundCloud. It's simple, but whatever.
Mate, let me just give you an example as to why I don't use SoundCloud for podcasts. Let's say I have the Ear Biscuits thing. I have the Ear Biscuits. I have the most recent one on any other freaking app but SoundCloud. You can hit download while I'm at home. So when I'm out using it, I don't use any sort of data.
Mm.
That's pretty nice. But, yeah. I mean, you know, whatever.
No, I was using SoundCloud because they you linked it on their Facebook.
Yeah, and you listen to all those Thomas the Tank Engine remixes, well, you know yeah, what I'm saying?
That's not where I found it, though. I didn't even go to SoundCloud. They linked their SoundCloud on there, so.
Yeah. Anyways, that probably didn't make too much sense for people who don't know what we're talking about. Anyways, so what have we been playing recently? We'll save the best for last. Don't do it yet.
Well, I've been playing Infamous.
Oh, yeah.
Getting that platinum. I still don't have it. I gotta find those sign twirlers and street musicians.
You're pretty close, though.
I'm close.
Yeah.
I only need a few more of them.
He went through the evil playthrough on expert.
So, okay, I still had districts in the top on my good playthrough. Dang. That still was, like still DUP controlled. Yeah. So, like, in that matter of, like, hour and a half, I was like, bam, wiped it clean. I got all those.
Yeah, because it doesn't take much to clear a district, but, like, if you don't.
The last two.
If you're not doing it, you know.
Yeah, right. The last two ones were really tough though, because yeah. there's like turrets everywhere.
Yeah, and then you call in the lady, and you're like, somebody yeah. deface the sign again.
It's hilarious. Yeah.
It's great, and she's like, stop doing it.
Stop great. Doing it.
The first time he called, he was like, ooh, you sound sweet. Yeah. No. But yeah, I love that game so much. So you're very close to the platinum on that. That's awesome.
Yeah. So that'll be my first platinum.
Yeah. Yeah, dude. Congrats when it happens. Mm-hmm. You don't get my congrats yet. But yeah. when it does. What else have you been playing? Second Son? Play a little bit of Helldivers because of the event.
A tiny bit of Helldivers.
Yeah. To anyone who...
Not as much... I mean, I got rank 4 in Destiny and Iron Banner to get... Jolder's Hammer, and I rerolled two of them. I bought two of them, which was like 22,000.
That's a lot of money, yes.
And then I ran out of motes on my second gun.
Yeah.
I got the best PvP machine gun, though. Mm-hmm. Like, build.
Nice. That's pretty cool. I can't stand the Iron Banner, so I didn't do it. I would have liked the gun, but I played it a little bit. I played it a little bit by myself, and I was like, I can't do this. Mm. I can't. So, yeah, but anyways, to the people who have Helldivers and play it, actually, it's almost, I bet it's done, dude, the event.
What, the sale?
Yeah, it's probably done. But the bug homeworld was able to, like, have a war. There was, like, a 48-hour event where, like, the community attributed to it. Yeah, it's done. Did the bugs take over? Did we win?
Probably.
It looked like the bugs were going to win by a landslide. But next time that happens, be on it. Be leveled up so you can wreck those bugs and those cyborgs and whatnot. But... anything else that you've been playing that's other than the big one?
well, I played something else on Steam. I played some Battlefield. I did pistols only, and then snipers only, and I failed horribly because I was playing console for the past several months, and I go try to play a PC FPS. It doesn't go that well.
No. There, it's crazy how much of it really is, like, getting used to it. Like, it really is a ton.
If I sat down and played Battlefield 4 on PC for like a week or two, I would probably feel for it.
Yeah.
But when you switch, you're just screwed for a while.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting. Because, like, when I switch to mouse and keyboard, say I have like a ton of experience on one game on a mouse and keyboard, and then I go play console for like a couple of months, and then I come back, I still have to relearn that. But if I leave console for a while and come back,
I
have to relearn because it's a freaking awesome controller. But yeah.
Yeah. Well, I think what it is that when you have a console, when you're on the controller, you have most buttons do the same thing on every game.
Yeah.
On PC, lots of games have different inputs.
Yeah, they can be very different.
So,
I think that's true. Yeah. But
The biggin.
Yeah, the biggin. Actually, yeah, I'll say what I've been playing, then we'll say what we have both been playing, which is really awesome. Anyways,
Really?
Destiny, but not, like, you know.
Avidly.
Avidly. Dude, Nate just said sup in in Skype. I'm gonna say doing the podcast right now.
Shout out to a podcast.
Well, shout out. Anyways, I just thought it would be interesting. But, yeah, shout out to Nate. He's been out of town. He's got a bunch of different Snapchats doing some weird stuff. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, he's living life.
Living like Larry. Anyways, Destiny, but not too much. A little bit, you know. There's always a little bit of Destiny. Helldivers was fun. Like I said last week, DC Universe is pretty damn good. That was good. I played that a lot, like up until like Friday. I feel like there's one other thing, but I can't remember what it was.
You playing Lego Batman at all?
No, I've meant to go back to that, but I haven't. I will one day. I'm gonna get that platinum.
I feel like you've been playing. You played Persona. We played.
I've been playing some more Persona. That game is freaking Persona.
It's so perfect.
So good. It's so good. Okay. Now let's let's move on to the big one. Me and Eric purchased a game recently on that.
It was actually Gabby. Gabby. Yeah. I saw Gabby purchase this game. I was like,
Eric was like, I wonder if I should get this. And then he told me about it, and I was like, I wonder if I should get this. And then in a moment of weakness, you were like,
nah.
Yeah, at first I was like, nah. But in a moment of weakness, I caved, and I purchased it. So basically, Eric and I have been playing a ton of Elder Scrolls Online, Tamriel Unlimited. Did you know, by the way, the Tamriel Unlimited version came out last Tuesday?
Yeah. Like, I knew it came out
very recently.
The difference is just it not having a subscription, right?
Yeah, and I think they rolled out the most recent update with it.
Which is fixes and stuff?
There was some gameplay stuff. I don't know what it was, but there's an update. So the game came out last Tuesday. If you're a PC player and are interested in MMOs, I have to tell you right now
is buy this game.
Right now
buy it.
Is the best time
it's
to buy it.
So good.
No subscription.
Yeah, there's no subscription.
$60. I mean, it's a full game. I've already got my $60
for it. It's a full MMO. Like, holy. It's so good. There's no tab combat, which is awesome. The combat is freaking.
I mean, you can use tab to switch between. But
it's not tab combat though. Tab combat is its own thing. It's not like freaking where you go up and you press tab and you press one.
Two, the button.
Yeah, it's just like this one, and then they're dead. Tab. This one. I hate that. This is freaking, like you have normal attacks. Yeah, you have normal attacks with your left mouse button, like you can slash with your sword and whatnot.
Block
with your right mouse button, and then if you see an enemy casting a spell, you can hold both to interrupt them, and then you can hold the left mouse button, do a heavy attack, and then you can you have all your spells as well. But also, you can cast all your spells while moving. Your spells are, they don't have cooldown.
But they are magicka.
They take a decent amount of magicka, but still, like, no cooldown. If you wanted to, like I actually just did, you just spam an ability until it's gone. It's pretty. Oh, it's so good.
Yeah, abilities are based off of your stamina and magicka,
But it's pretty that.
So you've been playing that for like
it's
the past.
So good. Day. Yeah, I played it. I played it for the first time last night with Gabby and Eric, and basically we were running along the road. We saw this chick who was like, "Hey, help me out!" And I was like, "Yo, what you want?" And she said that basically her whole crew, like she was a captain of a ship, her whole crew was like lost in a hurricane. So we went out and found her crew, and then we went to go find one of them, and one of them was dead in a cave with like strange ritual markings on him. So we go ask, like, a captain nearby, like, of another ship, and be like, yo, what do you think that was? And he was like, yo, it might be these pirate dudes. So yeah. We go and investigate these pirate dudes, and these pirate dudes are creating hurricanes. So we swim out into the storm. There's freaking lightning going off. We're swimming out into there, and then we jump onto their ship, and we kill two of these guys that are freaking calling down lightning and all this. And then the storm disappears, and it's like bright as day. And then we swim back and complete
our quest. The best thing part of that is that it's a side quest.
Yeah, the best part of that was that was a side quest. That was not the main story. We were just running along, and that happened. Like, oh my gosh, it's really, really good. Like, I was gone this morning, and I went to sleep early last night, and like, all I wanted to do was to get home and to play more. I have to leave right after this. All I'm going to want to do is to get home and play more. After The Walking Dead, I'm going to jump back on. It's going to be freaking
play
awesome.
Play with me and my friend, our friend Gabby.
Yeah. It's very good. Like, seriously, at least
9 consider. Out of 10. 9.9.
Dang. Holy crap. But to be honest, the things that I've actually heard about it is that the end game is like a little bit lacking compared to others.
That's probably why a lot of people don't like it, is the end game is eh.
Yeah, I don't know. I really want to I'm optimistic. I hope it's decent. But so yeah, buy the game. Buy it. They're not offering character transfers. They're from like PC to PS4, like, to be honest, I'm probably going to buy the PS4 version as well, just to play with like Andrew and some other friends, because, and also I like playing on PlayStation, but I was hoping that they would have character transfers, but they're only having character transfers for people who bought it like before June 30th of last year. Basically, I think the whole thing with that is because like they struck up a deal with Sony and Xbox where, like, if you pre-ordered the console version and then bought it on PC because you couldn't wait, you know, type of thing.
Right.
Then they'll let you have character transfers. But like for me, who just really wants to play it on the other system, no,
it's not the same.
I don't get it. So thanks, Cinemax. Gosh dang it.
Yeah, they could just make the whole thing crossplay, and everyone would be in the happy world.
Yeah, I wish, dude.
Wait. Does this mean we can play with you while you're on PS4?
No. That's what cross play does mean.
cross play as in like I can go on my PC and level up 5 times and go on my PS4 on the same character and level up 5 more times.
That is cross save. Cross play is basically having the same server. Like PS3 and PS4 DC Universe are cross play. Like, yeah, that doesn't change it.
There's two mega servers.
It doesn't change it. They would have to have mega servers. Mega servers. 3 times, there's because it would servers. Be 3 different systems.
They're not going to make more servers for consoles, are they?
No. Well, they will, but they'll make servers specifically for console, but they're not going to combine them with the PC servers.
That would be cool.
I know. That would be awesome. But it's not gonna happen. But
wow. Where's this going?
Wow. But I don't know. I feel like it'll be fun. Hopefully I'll be able to convince Andrew to get it, and then maybe Jay Money, and then maybe Ryan, and it'll just be awesome. It'll be freaking great. But
I mean, I would get it. Just, I really it's freaking in terms of money.
Yeah, true. But for now, it's so good. I don't even, like, I haven't jumped off of my PS4 in like months because I have tons of games there that
you
I
don't
like
but
I jumped off
PC.
Yeah, I jumped off the other day just because of this, because I was like, yeah, I guess, and then I bought it, and then I was like, yeah, I'm gonna play it because I bought it, and then I jumped on and I played it, and I'm like, now I'm like, I just want to play this game. So sadly, PS4, but if it was on PS4, then I would still be over there.
Right.
But it's not. So I'm excited to play more. It's really good so far. At least the beginning leveling experience is awesome.
Just be true.
Anyways, let's
Story
move on.
Topics.
Yeah, let's move on. We actually have a decent amount. But we can talk about these, and then we can move on to the...
what we watch?
Yeah, because Walking Dead was pretty insane. Oh my gosh, yeah. Right. Yeah. I thought about that before I started. I was like, dang, we can talk about Walking Dead for a while. But, okay, so how about you lead us off with what you think? Because you got to... I don't know about that. There's a bunch of stuff here.
Okay. Well, since I played Infamous, I guess I'll go ahead and say that I was playing Infamous on the anniversary of it.
Yeah. Yeah, dude.
So, which is awesome.
Yeah, I saw like PlayStation or Sucker Punch tweet out something about like happy birthday Infamous Second Son. And then I looked on my friends list and I was like, oh, Eric's playing it. That's so fitting. That's so nice. Cool. But basically, you know, PlayStation blog posted. They got two ringtones, the Delson ringtone, the normal one, which I actually used for a long time, and then Fetch's ringtone. And then they announced that on March 31st, they're going to have a Fetch and a Delson theme for PS4. They're going to be $2 each. Sweet. And some wallpapers and all that. So check that out if you're interested.
So some festive celebratory stuff.
Yeah, I really wish that themes were free though. Like I would instantly put on that Delson theme.
I mean, maybe they hired some artist and were like, hey, draw something.
Well,
and
you'll
reap the rewards.
Yeah, click on the link, dude. Freaking look at the actual theme for Delson. It's awesome. Like here. I'll bring it over power. To people who are watching the video version. Look at that crap. It's at the bottom.
Yeah.
Like that's really good. I like that a lot. If I got $2 to throw around, I might just toss it on that. But so yeah, go play Infamous Second Son. Go get that platinum if you haven't.
You know, I was thinking I could save this image. I could save this image and put it as my Facebook cover.
It's true, but is it big enough? That's the question.
I don't know. I'll try it. In the meantime.
Yeah. So yeah, happy birthday. Go play it. Platinum it. So, yeah. Also, yeah. Have you seen the episode 4 of Powers, dude?
No, I still need to see 3.
Okay, we'll talk about up until episode 5 next week, I guess. Also, you have not rented and played The Order yet, so we still haven't talked about that.
Yeah,
even though it's like a month after the release. But you still should. Like, I still say you should. Like, yeah. I don't care if we talk about it late. Like, I think you should just for the story. Like, the story is actually very good. Since we haven't talked at all about The Order, and it might be a while, I still say play it. It's not a great game by any means. I don't know if it's even a good game. I think it's good.
Enjoyable.
Yeah. I'm very on the fence. It's like in between okay and good. It's like, it's not just okay, but it's not good. You know, it's like right in the middle. But the story and the characters are awesome. Like, the universe is really cool. They really do have something there. So, buy that game and or rent it and play it just in the hopes of the sequel. Because the sequel will be very good if they improve on it. So...
See, I put it on my cover.
Oh my gosh, you put it on your cover? Did it actually work?
Kind of.
Kind of? Does that mean it was super small?
No.
Oh, okay. Here, let me take a look. I'll bring it over for the video version. It kind of works.
Yeah.
Kind of works. Kinda. It's all right. I like it. So I want to discuss something that is very interesting. Also, I put this article on the Google Doc twice. So let me delete one of these. So this is like the biggest piece of actual gaming news throughout the week. Nintendo announced that they are making a new console, and they like already announced
that. I saw that.
Very interesting. They also, so basically what they did was they announced that they are bringing some of their IPs to the mobile platform. And then with that, they also announced Codename NX, which is a code name for their new console, that is like them saying, we're bringing our new IPs to mobile, but we're also committed to our home console as well.
What if they just pulled, like, I don't even have like a reference, but like they just made this new console, had third party support, and just like went all out.
What if they did that? What if they did that and then released it with this announcement just randomly? Just like randomly one day in March was just like, oh, here it is. And here is a bunch of...
Fine, guys. Stop rewinding. We'll give you third-party support and all these other games that you wanted on here.
That would be great, but it... Yeah. I don't know if that's going to happen. But NX is supposed to stand for, like... I don't know what the N is, but the Nintendo X is supposed to be, like...
Nintendo 10.
I think it's actually supposed to stand for, like, Nintendo Crossover or something. Like, the X is supposed to be referencing, like, Crossover. But...
So I can't play Smash Bros. With other people on my PC.
On your PC. On your PS4, getting trophies, but playing a Nintendo game. But basically what I think is that some people were like, oh, what if it is crossover of like other systems? I don't think it's that. I think it's a cross-platform system of a DS type thing. And the home console, like, basically, like, you have your DS, and you can go, and then you come home, and you turn it on. Basically, kind of, it's, I think it'll be like how some Vita games are with the cross-save, but, like, all the time.
You know, it'd be really cool.
That would be awesome.
If they made, like, okay, it's like a little, it's like a tray, almost, maybe? And, like, not a tray, but, like... It's a platform, but it has like a plugin for every one of the Nintendo devices.
Yeah. Like
if you have a DS, bam. If you have a DS XL, bam. If you have the Wii U pad, bam.
I didn't think about that, but that's kind of insane.
That would be kind of insane.
But... Yeah, that's pretty awesome. Board, but that's not, that would never happen though, because they don't want to support their old stuff. They just want to market their new stuff. But at the same time, they do want to support their old games. So I don't know, because they keep re-releasing their old games. It's pretty. It's what Nintendo does best, is re-release their old games. Mm-hmm. So yeah,
that's a thing.
Yeah, that's the thing. They're not even talking about it until next year. Which they have already talked about it, though. So I don't know what they're thinking. Like, this is what Colin Moriarty says, and what I have said forever. Don't announce a game, like, 5 years in advance, you know? Like, freaking, what was it? It's the game by Gearbox that's, like, supposed to be the first-person MOBA-type thing that they're making. I think it might have blood in the name. I don't know. But it. I know there's a B in it. But basically, I think it might be like Battle something. Yeah.
Battletoads.
Yes, Battletoads. Yeah. But basically, they announced it. And then when they announced it, it was on the Game Informer cover. And was like, oh, here's all these details. There's this character. There's this. You could do all this in the map. And then they're like, oh, it comes out in 2 years. I'm like, why would you release all those details when it comes out 2 years later? I don't understand marketing sometimes. Like, from a consumer standpoint, I don't get it. I don't get why you would announce The Last Guardian when it's not ready 12 years later.
Colin wants to say that's going to come out this year. What?
he said that it's going to come out every single year. For real. Like, that's hilarious. His E3 bet every year. Is like The Last Guardian will get a release date like every year. But yeah, announce games closer to release, please. I'm begging you. But
yeah,
so there's actually some other interesting stuff on here. Here's one that I'll cover, and then you can talk about the Star Wars thing, because I'm sure you're excited for that. I'm also excited for it, but Visceral is, or DICE is actually the one developer.
Yeah, DICE.
Also, you know how we were talking about Amy Hennig the other day and where she was working now, yeah. What project she might be working on? She's working with Visceral, by the way, just in case you did not know. She's at Visceral Games. What
could they be doing?
It's not a KOTOR 3, sadly. Like, if I were to guess, yeah, it's not. Visceral, but I wish.
Visceral does... I mean, of course, they did Hardline, and they did Dead Space, so...
Interesting. That's an interesting combination. I didn't know they did Dead Space. That's...
Yep.
That's cool. I don't know, dude. Those are two very different games. So, they could be working on freaking anything. They could be working on a Star Wars RTS. But, with Amy Hennig as the writer, because that makes sense. But, I don't know. We'll figure out what that is soon, hopefully. Hopefully at E3. We'll see what she's working on. I hope. Eric is frozen right now for me. Look at that face. Freaking creepy. I will continue on until Eric gets here. I guess. Actually, this topic I don't want to talk about until he gets back, because he doesn't know it. So I'll go get him. I'll come back when he is here. And we're back. Resume the timer. Just my internet decides to randomly leave me for 20 seconds, and it does that a lot. I don't know. Maybe it's my... No, it's not my router, because it's freaking Ethernet. I don't know what it is. It must be the provider. It just happened. It's been happening a lot lately.
Is that the poop for a little bit?
For real, it does. It goes for about 20 seconds every time and then comes back on its own. Like, I don't do anything. It leaves. It shows the little exclamation point on the network thing. And then I'll wait. And then it's back.
Maybe your dad illegally downloads movies.
Maybe he does. Maybe he does.
He has a whole server of illegally downloading.
If my dad was illegally downloading anything, it would be like history documentaries. Like, anyways, let's talk about this piece of news that you actually don't know if I am guessing correctly, basically. So,
I didn't know that.
In Powers episode 3, I think, I think it was 3.
About 2.
Was it 2?
Yeah, it was Point Infamous.
Yeah, 2's right, yeah. Yeah, it was in Powers episode 2. Basically, this dude was chilling on the flow. I don't know why he was on the flow. But he was playing Infamous. He's got his gold wireless headset on. In Powers, there's so much Sony placement. It's great. It's hilarious. It's like freaking Sony Vios everywhere. His freaking gold headset. He's got the PS4 controller. Mm-hmm. But basically what they did was they showed him video chatting with somebody as they play. Nice. He was playing a Infamous Second Son clone where, like, it was Infamous Second Son, but they put, like, a different character model on him, and they were basically talking like it was some online MMO or something. And so he was talking to this chick, and the big piece of news is that they were showing the, like, video chat as a function on the PS4, and I thought this wasn't really a piece of news, but then I scrolled down, and it says... this is no way a confirmation of how video chat functionality will look on PS4. This is an article on IGN by Michael Martin, by the way. Mm. It says, however, Sony hopes to have video chat on PS4 in Q2 2015.
Mm.
So what? It says, through an app called Uvu, according to the CES 2015 interview.
Uvu.
So, yeah, they are integrating Uvu into PS4.
It's, dude, like a bad version of Skype.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with Uvu. From my understanding, it works, but, like, from what it was before, which is just another version of Skype, I was like, why would I ever use this? But, to be honest, this is a good business move for Uvu. Like, freaking integrate it with PS4. You have no business being on PC where it's monopolized by Google Hangouts and Skype.
Right.
Like, you're not going to do anything there. But, like, if this is a thing and it works, I'll probably use it a decent amount. Me and you hang out in PlayStation Party Chat a lot. And Ryan and Andrew and whatnot. So,
yeah.
So, yeah. True. Ignore the Skype sounds as well. But, I hope this comes. Like, this is cool, right?
Yeah, cool, I mean, if it's quality and it's not invasive of your game or anything.
Yeah.
Yeah,
like, one of the things that I'm actually jealous of Xbox One for is the Skype
integration.
That's so cool. And the snap features, like, you can be watching a video through the IGN app or through YouTube,
yeah,
and snap where you can see it in part of the screen, and you can also be playing your game. Like,
see, that's
why is that not on PS4? Also, one more thing.
Xbox is Microsoft.
Yeah,
and
true.
They have billions of dollars
to make, like,
Xbox
OS and whatnot.
Yeah, different OSs.
But also, one more thing that I'm jealous of Xbox for. The freaking... They added... This is a thing on achievements now, Eric. They have progress bars on
for
achievements.
Like...
It's like, say you need to collect this many amount... And like,
oh,
collect all the blast shards in Infamous.
Yeah.
You would see how many blast shards you have out of
that's
how many.
That's pretty legit. Yeah.
Like, why don't we have that? That's so
you know,
cool.
As much as I
that's
like
so cool.
trophies, not achievement, getting achievements on Xbox, I don't like the gamer score system that much because it's just numbers. Okay,
yeah.
You got 25 score for this, 25 score for that. I mean, one trophy is fine.
I like the
level system.
Yeah. To be honest, as a newcomer to... Like, imagine you're a newcomer to both systems. You go to the achievements, and it's basically like, say, you see somebody with an achievement, like a gamer score of, like, I don't know, 25,000.
25,000 is an average.
Yeah,
like someone...
but see, me going in, I have no idea. I don't know if that's average, I don't know if that's good, I don't know if that's great. It's just a number to me. But with PlayStation, like, you go in and you see a level. Like, if I see a level 20-something on PlayStation, I would automatically assume that's probably pretty good. And also, whenever you view somebody's trophy account, like, whenever you view their profile for trophies, it shows this amount of plats, your level, this amount of golds, and this amount of silvers, and this amount of bronzes. Like, whenever you look at it.
It's pretty simple and straightforward.
Yeah. Yeah, I like it. But then again, a lot of people just, I don't know. They're at the same time, they're very similar. Like, they're almost the same thing.
Yeah, they're it's the same thing, only every achievement on Xbox is like has a worth.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that's honestly how it is on PlayStation.
Well, on PlayStation,
bronze,
you have
silver,
the,
gold.
Yeah, but
they...
they're not in numbers. They're in, like, status.
Yeah, true. But, like... A gold gets you way higher in percentage of level to your next level than a bronze
one. Let me see how much gamer score I have.
Oh, gosh.
Okay, I have 18,000. That's pretty much average. Around 20,000 is average.
Yeah.
If I actually put work into it, I could probably get 30,000.
I wonder how much Ray from Achievement Hunter has. Probably like 200,000. Anyways,
I don't know, man.
Do you want to talk about the Star Wars news, and then we can talk about our TV shows? Oh, and your other piece that you actually added. Eric has a piece. Eric has a topic on the Google Doc for once.
Well, let's see. Star Wars Battlefront. It's gonna be at some Star Wars thing. I thought it was gonna be at E3 when they started announcing stuff, but given it's gonna be released this year. They're probably going to give us some gameplay and a release date. Hype for Battlefront. Star Wars Battlefront, made by DICE.
Yeah, basically Battlefront is like, they just announced that they were... What's cool about this is that they haven't backed down at all. Like, somebody asked them recently, they're like, yo, EA, will Battlefront be coming out this year still since we haven't seen much? And they were like, yes, it's coming out in the fall of 2015. And that was, like, a couple of days ago. So, this article is basically just them saying, like, we'll probably see Battlefront in April. It's, like, some sort of Star Wars, like, conference or something. Freaking conference. I imagine that, like, a giant meeting. And it's all the guys dressed in Star Wars gear. Like, sitting around. Like, all the, like, in the old episodes with the guys in the Empire gear. All sitting around and Darth Vader's talking to them all, you know? Yeah. Don't know why that popped into my head. Anyways, they are showing off the game sometime in April. So hopefully we'll get a release date. Here it is. This year's annual Star Wars celebration takes place in Anaheim, California between April 16th and 19th. So April 16th and 19th, hopefully we will see something about the game, information, gameplay. Because we haven't seen any gameplay other than like really, really early access footage like once. So
yeah, that's true.
I'm very excited. It's going to be cool.
Yeah.
Also, Eric put on his own topic. Yeah. I'm so all right. Proud.
I gotta go into this a little bit.
I'm so
but,
proud.
All right. So even though it's a teaser, here I'll give you a link since I actually have a link for one of my.
Oh my gosh! It's going down. I'm yelling timber. Is that not the link? That's a Tumblr.
That's it. It's right there. Oh, sorry. Okay. But anyway, you can play that for people. If you actually don't, because people are giving strike, their Microsoft is getting out strikes for doing that. Just watch it. But anyway, in the teaser, pretty much I have to explain it. There's a bullet that says traitor, and the other side says hero. And it's going into Master Chief's helmet and exploding it, very thoroughly. But it's symbolism for what they've been teasing. There's this guy, Sergeant Locke, who is the main character in Halo Nightfall. Apparently, from what it looks like, he's being sent out by Oni, which is like the secret service of the future.
Yeah.
Probably to track down and assassinate Master Chief because he left the UNSC, which is pretty much the army of the future. So that's what it looks like, and it's really got me excited because it's kind of like anti-hero, maybe the government is going to be the bad guys type of thing.
Yeah, so, I don't normally like that stuff, but I do like the ideas of like running from the government even though you know you're doing good. Like, I don't like running from the government because you're actually doing something bad. But, like, Batman being tracked down is kind of a cool concept.
Here's the thing. I think you're going to be able to play as Sergeant Locke, tracking down Master Chief.
Yeah.
Because they did that in Halo 2 where you could play as Arbiter, which is a...
I have heard a lot about Sergeant Locke. So,
really?
Most things that I've heard about Halo 5 are about him. So
yeah, it's true.
It wouldn't surprise me.
Sergeant Locke is good. Like, I mean, even the cover of Halo 5 is Sergeant Locke on top and then Master Chief on bottom, I think.
Yeah, like, they
upside down.
They definitely seem like there's something up their sleeve. Like that, it'll be more.
There's gonna be a conflicting force between them two people. Yeah, I can see that though.
Yeah.
So I am excited for that because it's not the usual Halo story where you go shoot up aliens.
No.
If
it's on PC, which, oh my gosh. If it was on Windows 10, I would just die. But if it is, like, I will definitely play it, even though I have not played any Halo games. I will. Okay. If it was. But, yeah, that was a pretty dang cool teaser.
In 3 hours, they're about to show probably some sort of trailer.
Oh, snap.
On this thing, so.
Oh, dang.
That's a thing.
So, here we are, like every week, down to TV talk. That is all. That's all the topics of news and whatnot that were very important in the past week. But now it's time to talk about things that really mattered, like The Flash.
No 100
ever again. They've killed it. They've taken it out back and shot it, and there's no 100. I'm just kidding. It'll be back.
It'll be back in 5 years. That's what it'll feel like.
Definitely what it'll feel like. Gosh, dang it! Why did they take that show? And
yeah, it's gonna be well before we hear from.
Maybe in the end, all these delays for Flash and Arrow are a good thing because they prolong.
We can still talk about Flash
and Arrow. But let's start off. Let's start off before we get to Flash and Arrow.
Walking Dead.
So
I'll just say this, Rick. And Carol is insane. Rick and
Carol's insane. Also, I just wanna, before we start off, spoilers. Now, I gave him a break to turn it off if they hadn't seen
like
The Walking Dead.
Just put, like, red flashing light. Spoiler.
The... Rest in peace, Noah, is all I have to say. Rest.
Everybody ate Chris.
Wow. Wow.
Limb for limb.
Oh my gosh. The way you said that, Eric, I was on my camera, but you guys probably didn't see it. I was, he was just saying it, and then he was like, limb for limb, tossed something in his mouth and ate it. He's just eating goldfish all casual. He's like, yep, limb for limb. Not a big deal or anything. My goodness. Have but some respect.
Everybody ate Chris.
Yeah, they did. They ate him real good. So basically what happened is the dudes went on a run. You know, the guys that, oh, we know what we're doing. We go on runs all the time.
And we never die.
We never die. I don't know if they ever said that. But they went on their run with Glenn.
And Noah.
Yeah, Noah.
And
Tara, I think is her name.
And Eugene.
Yeah, and Eugene. They all went out. And basically, one of the guys got, like, pretty much got, like, impaled.
He shot a grenade.
Yeah, he shot a grenade.
Blew himself into some shrapnel and got impaled by it.
Also, wait, before we go into, like, the big stuff, which is, like, the Noah thing, was there anything else that happened? Big, at least, sort of, kind of big?
I can't think of anything else.
Yeah, I can't either.
Carol made some cookies.
Carol made some kid.
And threatened him again.
Yeah. Other than that. Oh! Okay, we'll talk about the Noah thing, and then we'll talk about the ending with Carol and why she's insane. So, okay. Noah basically... So, yeah. We're back to the Noah scene. The dude impales himself. They go up to him, and Glenn's trying to get him off, and he's like, you guys help me. And Noah's being a boss and holding off all the zombies while they're trying to get him off. And then the other guy's like, you know our way, dude. I gotta get out of here. And so the other guy that was part of Alexandria stops.
Mm-hmm. He was like, no, I can't do this. I can't do this.
And he runs away. So, like, okay. And then the other guy was like, Glenn, it's fine. This is how we work. And then Glenn, like, kept trying, and then all the zombies, and Noah pulled Glenn away, like, the second before all the zombies just freaking
they should have shot
that guy.
Before they
See,
left. Oh,
you
gosh.
Said that, but they didn't have time. Glenn was still not giving up on getting him off. Glenn was still trying to get him off, and then they pulled Glenn away from him, like, the second before all the zombies.
They let him get eaten.
Which is
way worse than what...
But Glenn thought he could get him off. And he was also in super shock that the guy just left him. Like, his friend was like, see you later.
Yeah, seriously, that really shocks me, because we're so used to, like, the team helping out everyone no matter what.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Seeing people just, like, do that to their friends, it's ridiculous.
Yeah. And so, basically, we're down. Eugene and Tara are injured, by the way. And Eugene, like, carried Tara out to the car.
Tara was knocked out or something.
Yeah, Tara was knocked out, and Eugene carried... Eugene got balls, which is also a big point.
There were three balls.
There were multiple points that happened in this, like, important things. So
dubstep. Yeah, that's what it is. Dubstep, dude.
Dubstep. Knife party.
Dubstep. Yeah, knife party was up in the house.
It's
hilarious.
Good.
I think I laughed for a good 5 minutes at that.
It was pretty funny. But so Eugene carries her out to the car. Now it's down to Glenn, Noah, and the other dude from Alexandria. They get stuck in a revolving door.
Thing is, right here, okay. They're stuck in a revolving door. There's one on one side, the dude from Alexandria. Then there's Glenn and Noah on the other side.
Yeah.
They have to push on both sides to give it balance.
Yeah.
I guess this. Okay, there's zombies on both sides. One of the sides are going to get cleared. Probably outside, because it's the easiest way to
Well, people. I mean, we all guessed it.
I didn't think anyone would die.
Yeah, I didn't think anyone would die.
People were going to be forced to, like... push one side.
Yeah. So basically, Eugene, like, came up blaring the knife party, and it cleared all the zombies over to him. And
bring in the knife party.
Oh, dude, this killed me. So what happened was Noah and Glenn are over here in one, and the other dude's over here by himself. What happens is that Glenn was like, "All right, give me a second. I'm gonna break this glass." So he hits it once, and the guy's like, "It's not gonna break. It's not gonna break." And then what he does is he stops pushing on his side, and he goes over and like literally squeezes himself out. And he's like,
"Bunch murders."
And yeah, it wasn't. It's pretty much...
When he was pushing that door, that's him pretty much shoving a knife in the way of his heart.
It wasn't like him, it wasn't like an easy, like, let me just, it's like, here, let go or pull me up. And he let go because he couldn't hold on anymore type of thing. It was like, I am purposefully gone. Like, he wiggled himself out and they were yelling at him. And he was like, "Nah, I don't care. Getting out." So he wiggled himself out. No one got grabbed. Because it revolving down. Door, he
wiggled. And the worst thing is that Noah was like, "Don't." Oh wait, what is it? What did he say?
"Don't let go."
Don't let go. Yeah.
But and I was like, he didn't say "don't let go" because, like, he knew he knew he was dead.
He knew he was dead.
He knew he was gone. But poor Noah, man. What was also pretty tragic was that at the beginning of the episode, he. Talked to like the architecture guy and was like, I want to learn how to do this, how to like build walls and whatnot. And he gave him a notebook and he wrote like, "This is the beginning" or something in it. And after he died and they were riding back in the car, the camera zoomed in on the notebook that said, "This is the beginning." And I'm like, dang it. GG.
Yeah.
Get wrecked, Noah, sadly. Noah's awesome. I didn't want him to die.
He was such a good character. Like,
yeah.
He's better than Daryl, almost, I think.
It was sad. But, yeah, that's the giant thing that happened. There's two more things that happened that were pretty big. Eugene was out helping, like, build... He was helping repair the wall, I think, or maybe it was expand the wall. He was out doing some sort of construction thing with the group. And basically, one of the people got left behind, and they did the same thing that the other guy did at the Noah thing. He was like, "It's our way, just leave him." And then freaking Eugene.
Oh, yeah, that's right. No, that was, Abraham.
Yeah, Abraham. I keep calling Abraham Eugene. Abraham was like, "What are you talking about? No."
Cover all the angles. Go.
So he like runs in and just starts shooting everything himself and pulls the person out. And yeah, so Eugene took over and was a boss. That was freaking not Abraham. So that was the thing. And then Gabriel went to the leader of Alexandria.
Oh my gosh.
And was like, "The devil disguises himself as an angel of light." And he is. He basically was like, "I know these people sound like good people, but they're really bad people, and they're coming to destroy your thing." And it's like, really, dude? What are you talking about? Why are you doing this? They saved your life countless times. Why?
I mean, yeah, they did. They've had to do some pretty screwed up stuff and kill a lot of people. But it doesn't matter because they were saving themselves.
Yeah, like Rick said, it was all about survival. Gabriel's a freaking idiot. I hope he dies.
Yeah. Sorry.
It's pretty brutal, but it's the truth. I don't even care. So, yeah. The Walking Dead. No. Carol. Actually, do you want to explain what happened to Carol? Because that's... Okay.
I don't remember what happened to Carol.
Not what happened to her. What she said at the end.
Okay. So, I think it was... Rick is, like, getting really upset at that one chick's husband that's, abusing.
Yeah, they found out Carol found out that he was abusing the kid and her, and she told him.
And so, I think Rick's primal instinct is getting all hyped up. Kill this dude.
Getting all hyped up.
And Carol is not helping here, making the situation worse, but it's like, "You need to kill him."
Yeah, basically Carol told him this, and then she was like, you know what you're going to have to do, Rick? You're gonna have to kill him." And it's like, no, you're not gonna have to kill him.
No, you have to kill him. You confront him and send him to authorities. You are the authorities.
Yeah, you are the authorities. You know how to do this. You've done this a billion times before the apocalypse because you were a police officer. You know how to take people down without killing them. So.
I don't get it.
Yeah, Carol's
nuts. Carol's just insane.
Yeah, Carol's insane. So, Walking Dead talk. pretty awesome. I'm excited for tonight. But Walking Dead season 5 is really good.
Like, yeah, it's good.
It's probably the best in a long time. Let's talk about Arrow, then leave the best one for last, The Flash.
Okay.
Arrow was not too much happened. Wait. I mean, let's see. They came home because, you know, it ended with Ra's being like, I want you to be the next Ra's.
Hold on a second.
What?
Did we not watch Arrow together?
No. We did not. Oh my gosh. Have you not watched it?
I don't even
it?
Think I saw it.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Well, to be honest, not.
I mean, I'm not going to be upset if you.
Too much happens. Anything big. Like, I'm trying to think if there's anything giant that happened. Yeah, there was some pretty big stuff at the end, but I don't want to spoil it because it was awesome. Oh well, sorry. If you look forward to Arrow Talk, it doesn't. You guys watch Arrow Talk
in our specific podcast.
Yeah, if you watch Arrow and look forward to Arrow Talk, you know what happened in the episode. You know it was awesome. Me and you got it. We got a connection here, and we'll move on. So, The Flash. Barry Allen. Dude.
Barry Allen.
Barry as in like Teddy, the bear in Persona. Anyways.
Barry awesome.
Wow.
Anyway.
That's all I have to say.
Time travel.
It was a thing. So the episode was kind of normal up until like the last 15 minutes where like everything happened. So, oh my gosh. So, basically what he did was he was trying to stop this, tsunami, and by the end, he just time traveled. Like, all this insane plot stuff happened, and then he was trying to stop this tsunami by running so fast, and he ran so fast, he ran to a point that was earlier in the episode, and it ended. I'm like, okay. It was... Dude, when they focused early on the episode, when they focused on him looking around and there were dogs barking and there was the woman going, I'm going to be late. I was like, why are they focusing on this?
Sounds like a Groundhog Day type thing.
Yeah, and then later they showed it again and I was like, oh, snap. I see. I get it. Clever job. But so let's reveal the big plot points that happened before he time traveled. So, do you want to start?
Okay, so
just name one of them.
Everything just happens. Like the writers just go all out on everything.
Yeah.
Well, Cisco is trying to look into Wells.
Yeah, he's suspecting.
That's
Wells.
The main thing, I think. And while that's going on, I think Wells already knows that Cisco's looking into it.
Yep.
Of course. And so Caitlin's being a distraction.
Yeah.
Not very good distraction.
This is a good setup for the giant thing that's about to happen.
And, you know. Oh my goodness. She's getting their coffees to go.
Not a big deal. Not a big deal.
And it turns around and he's gone. And she's shaking.
He's out of the wheelchair, which for someone who thought he was paralyzed and never was able to get out of the wheelchair.
She is now paralyzed.
His wheelchair was just empty. And she was like,
GG.
Yeah, that's exactly what she thought. GG, no re, and that was it. But, so.
And then, bam. There, beside Cisco.
Yep. Cisco was investigating the thing that they kept the man in the yellow suit in before. So, big things that happened that will probably be reversed because of the time travel. But Wells revealed himself, but even though it was reversed, we still, us as a viewer, now know things that we didn't know before. Wells is Eobard Thawne. Like, he named himself as the Reverse Flash. He just name-dropped the official thing. And then Cisco was like, it was so awesome. It was so awesome when it all happened. I think at a couple points I verbally, screamed some things. But he names himself. He was like, I'm actually Eobard Thawne. And Cisco was like Eddie? And he said, let's call him more of a distant relative. So we still am not sure what's going to happen with Eddie.
Wait, what? I think it's going to happen that Barry's going to finish the whole Weather Wizard thing a lot faster. And then he's going to go to Caitlin and ask, what were you going to, is there something? He's going to, like, anticipate, like, what's going on here.
Yeah.
And be like, hey, you wanted to talk about something.
That sounds...
Or maybe he interrupts Cisco.
Yeah, that sounds like the ideal thing, but I don't know if it's what he's going to do. Oh. That's what he should do. But it's definitely not going to go that well.
It's a little... I hope someone sees him out of his wheelchair, at least.
Yeah.
That's all I want.
Yeah. So, yeah. Some insane crap. Oh, wait. This isn't even the biggest stuff. So, let's explain the biggest stuff, and then I actually do have to leave very soon. We got, like, 2-3 minutes. So, what he does is he explains himself. He shows that he can create duplicates of himself somehow. Yep. Still not sure how I get that, but...
Oh, because...
pretty crazy stuff.
It was a time, like, thing...
Time anomaly, I think, is what he called
it. Yeah, it's like a copy of himself, because he's moving so fast that he can make a copy of himself that stands there.
I don't know. It was super intense. Then he basically gives Cisco this speech. Oh, dude, it was so good. And he was like, you really are smart, but to make Barry go faster, I have to protect him. And now that you know... And then he starts vibrating his hands super, super quick. And then he was like, I'm really sorry, Cisco. Because to be honest, I've actually grown quite fond of you. And really, I think of you more of like the son I never had. And then he goes, I'm sorry, but... And then this whole time, Cisco just single tear. And then he goes, I'm sorry, but... And then he freaking stabs him. And Cisco falls to the ground and you've been dead, but to me, you've been dead for centuries. And then walks out. I'm like, what? So, yeah. Insane stuff. Freaking kills Cisco. My immediate thought was like, he'll be fixed, hopefully, with the time travel. My immediate thought was like, but no vibe. He was going to be vibe. But, Cisco. That was something. Also, Iris... confessed her feelings to Barry and kissed him.
Gosh.
And then, even with all this, he goes, I'm sorry you have to find out this way. Freaking changes into the Flash in front of her and then goes to the tsunami. He's like, get out of here. And he runs.
Like,
and she's
hard.
Like, what? And then back in time. So all those awesome plot things just reversed.
Some I think it would be a lot more open about his relationship with Iris now.
Yeah, some might say it was... an episode like the Reverse Flash. It's like the episode. Dang it. I give up. I was trying to like title the episode like the Reverse Flash because so many things will be reversed. Eh? Mm-hmm. You get it now? Sort of?
Okay.
I'm done.
Drop.
Yeah. Drop. Ryan Clements, PlayStation Powerhouse, blah, blah, blah. Pretty important stuff actually this week. 2013 Infected Wars for the PS Vita. Not sure what this is. It looks interesting. Arcade Archives Matt Mania Exciting Hour PS4. Armored Core PS1 Classic. Bloodborne for the PS4. Bloodborne is coming out this week. Yeah, we're gonna
wait a second. The Handsome Collections coming out this week.
Yep, as well. This Tuesday. Borderlands Day.
Dang, dude.
PS4.
It's big.
I know it's huge. Damascus Gear Operation Tokyo PS Vita, Dead or Alive 2 Hardcore PS2 Classic, Lego Ninjago Shadow of Ronin PS Vita. That looks interesting. Metal Slug 3 PS4 PS3 PS Vita. Metal Slug, what the frick?
It's an like old arcade.
That
game.
Looks like a game I used to play on like a website in
it
like
probably
grade.
Is.
Slender the Arrival for PS4.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then the last one, saving the best for last. Yorby episode 1 : Payback's a Bolt. PS4.
Wow.
Payback is a Bolt.
Who makes this game?
I don't know. The evil Dr. Zox has taken control of the planet Yorbia Prime. I can't even.
Seriously.
I can't. So yeah, play Bloodborne, play the Handsome Collection, play Slender, I guess. Play games. Go for it. Yeah, play games. Play Elder Scrolls Online. Play DC Universe Online as well. Play Destiny. Yeah. Just play everything. Just everything. Play Bloodborne. Just all of it. Everything. All right. We'll see you next week after Eric hits me with something random that he's got around his room.
Yeah. All right.
I will describe it to the audio listeners if there are any.
All right.
Drum roll.
Now
you're like, I gotta find something.
Oh, here we go. This is a good one. Always have a ruler.
Ruler? Oh, big plays.
But here's the thing. This is not a normal ruler. No. It's a 15-inch ruler.
Never a normal ruler.
Not a foot ruler. A 15-inch ruler.
That's interesting for sure.
Yeah.
All right. Well, good thanks for watching. Yeah, good for math. Do your math, kids.
Yeah, do your math.
Do your math. Why are you watching this instead of your math? Go do your math. We'll see you next week. Bye.